Solar energy is growing rapidly here in New Mexico with a new facility open in Deming and plans by PNM to add 4 more solar plants. But some believe we're not really realizing our full potential here. The Green Chamber points to a shift by the Public Regulation Commission in 2013 that eased the requirement for the state's 3 largest utilities to acquire 20% of their electricity from renewable energies, by 2020. Now, critics say that stunted solar's growth here. And Laura, I have to ask you, you were involved with that a little bit at the time. Is there a direct connection here between that decision and where we are now in our solar climb? Has something been truly stunted here?
Well, so the decision that they made is they actually went back to change a rule that had already been set in 2012. They've actually since reconsidered even that change. So there's still, you know, rulemaking happening, and there's still a current rate case that's happening that could all impact, you know, utility scale solar.
Right.
I think one of the important takeaways that certainly the Green Chamber and people like myself that have been working in this area for a long time is that, you know, solar energy and wind energy, renewable energy, is rural economic development. For a lot of these small communities, Deming, you know, you mentioned Deming, which is where I'm from, these projects bring jobs, construction jobs, maintenance jobs, education opportunities, and they're really an investment in the rural health of our state.
Dan, what do you think?
I think that a big decline in solar in this state was when they took away the credits, the tax credits, when PNM made it very difficult to keep getting those credits, when they sucked them up so fast. I think something that the state has to look at and the regulators have to look at is PNM using those credits internally, saying we're going to build our own stuff. But it's we've got to figure out a way to address this. It's a huge need in Albuquerque alone, but it's an even bigger need in rural New Mexico, where it's just getting harder and harder to get reliable energy out to people's homes.
Well said. Rob, what do you think?
I'm pro-energy, I'm pro-business, but a couple of names pop right into my head. Shot Solar and Advent Solar, which together cost the state $31.5 million. And also, solar energy still gets subsidized at a very, very high rate.
If it can stand
100 times more, according to the federal government.
Interesting. We'll take that one on.
So I hear what you're saying about those, but we also see homegrown businesses like Sacred Power coming in and doing really interesting, really good work with solar, other providers in this area. You know, I think that the industry has legs, and we should be promoting it, especially in a sunny state like this.
The potential is
actually
amazing.
Albuquerque has over 80 different solar companies, solar manufacturing and solar installation.
We just saw the news that Germany, half of its power, cloudy Germany, is through renewables.
That's
we should be able to do at least that.
And I'll tell you, I know we're running over, Gene, but you know, there's a company in Albuquerque, Consolidated Solar Technologies, which has been not only in the cutting edge in New Mexico, they're in the cutting edge nationally on things that they're doing for governmental entities, bringing things in. And it's, you know, I could tell you, I know those folks intimately. You're talking about 50, 60 jobs that they brought to New Mexico that are here in Albuquerque, another dozen down in Las Cruces. They're talking about expanding in places like San Antonio and in the Midwest. I mean, you know, I know when you talk to the owners of Consolidated Solar, they say this is something that in 5 or 6 years could be 500, 600 employees nationally for this company.
Absolutely interesting.